إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, their companionship is Jannah. We all are seeking Jannah. That should be your goal, Jannah. A loser is someone who does not appoint this to be, designate this to be his goal. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us fi hadith Abi Huraira radiyallahu anhu wal hadith fil Bukhari, your deeds is not the reason to go to Jannah. اعلموا أنه لن يدخل أحدكم الجنة بعمله. Rather, the deeds are a requirement, are condition, a condition for you to receive the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get to Jannah. Because Jannah is priceless. Has no price. Enough. أنك ترى رب العالمين فيها. Enough that you see the face of Allah in Jannah. But so what you're looking for? Deeds that qualify you to receive the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get to Jannah. اعلموا أنه لن يدخل أحدكم الجنة بعمله. Rest assured that none of you will get to Jannah because of his or her deeds. قالوا ولا أنت يا رسول الله. Not even you, O Messenger of Allah. قال ولا أنا. He said, not even me. إلا أن يتغمدني الله برحمته. Unless Allah bestows his mercy upon you. Don't misunderstand. Don't stop working. Working is a condition to receive the mercy. So, in a way, you're looking for one deed. One deed that will qualify you to receive that mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed in your way a father and a mother. Right there. Right there. That is how you understand that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح مسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه دعا على من أدرك أبويه أو أحدهما ولم يدخلاه الجنة. He made dua against someone who comes to this world and he finds his father, his mother, or one of them alive, and they do not become the deed that would qualify him to receive the mercy of Allah to get to Jannah. بل إن أمين السماء وأمين الأرض دعيا عليهما على هذا الرجل أو هذه المرأة. The trustworthy of the heaven, Jibreel, and the trustworthy of the earth, Muhammad, made dua against that person. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في سنن الترمذي من حديث أبي هريرة, one day he climbed the pulpit and his pulpit made of three steps. He said, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. Then he faced his companions. And the companions, Rudwanullahi alayhim jami'a, asked him, O Messenger of Allah, you said Ameen, Ameen, Ameen three times. He said, Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as or while I was going up my pulpit, Jibreel came and made dua. Raghima anf, basically a loser. May he lose three times. Wadakara, one of the times, someone who comes to this dunya and he finds his father, his mother alive or both, and they do not become the deed that would qualify him to receive the mercy from Allah to enter Jannah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَ وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Your Lord has ruled that you are not to worship someone beside him. Accept him and to render good treatment to your parents. Ihsan. The word ihsan, a word that has no equivalent in English. هذا الإحسان, in your relationship with Allah سبحانه وتعالى, it means أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. That you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you see Allah. If you cannot reach that level, then the least you need to recognize that Allah sees you all the time. And this is the definition that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam given to Jibreel alayhi salam في الحديث المشهور وما الإحسان. What is إحسان, O Messenger of Allah? قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. You worship Allah as if you see Allah, if not the least Allah sees you. So this is إحسان in your relationship with Allah, that you're under surveillance camera all the time. Even if you go inside the room, shut the curtains, close the doors, Allah still sees you. Al-Ihsan. I'm trying to define the word Ihsan for you because look at this. وَقَضَى وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَاءُ وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. What does it mean, Ihsan? That you must be a muhsin. I cannot say an English word that can give you that meaning. I have to explain it. So ihsan with Allah, Allah sees me all the time. This is the lowest. A lower level than. Two, in the area of the acts of worship, Allah prescribed upon you 5 daily prayers. Allah prescribed upon you fasting the month of Ramadan. 2.5% of your mal, provided it meets the nisab and you own it for a year. Zakah. Minimum. Ihsan in the area of the acts of worship that you do more than the required. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Dhariyat, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ. Indeed, the righteous and the pious are in gardens, wells. Look, آخِذِينَ مَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ مُحْسِنِينَ. They used to be muhsins in the dunya. Here is the definition. كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ. Look, you're required to pray 5 times a day. You pray 5 times, you go to bed, khalas. If you want to do that. But no, they were muhsins. They pray tahajjud at night. They increase. وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ. There is no ma'loom here. حَقٌّ. In their wealth, there is a haqq. They believe that their money belongs to the poor and the needy. So, ihsan in the area of the ibadat, that you give more, you do more nawafil. Here is the one that we're looking for. Ihsan in the area of dealing with one another. That somebody slaps you here, you tell him, please go ahead. Slap me here. May Allah forgive you. Jazakallahu khairan, brother. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَةِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Why I'm saying all of this? Because Muslims right now, they are beginning to speak like non-Muslims. Even so, non-Muslims are not right. I get a father and a son in my office, and then the son complains about his father. He did this to me. Even if he did this to you, remember the standard that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set for your relationship with your father is ihsan. That you must return his evil with goodness. If you want to get to Jannah, these days they get them in interviews and televisions, and also were workout soap operas. Huh? If you did this and this and this and this and this to me, father. You did this and this. You can't do that with a father, no. Brothers and sisters in Islam, be careful if you are a son. Be careful if you are a daughter. You cannot adopt what you hear in the movies, in the pictures. You cannot adopt what you hear in the soap operas. You cannot. Some Muslim children now, they call their parents with their first names. Wallahi ra'aytu hadha bi ummi ayni. His father is Muhammad. Instead of telling him, ya abi, he says, Muhammad, ana bahibbak ya Muhammad. Bi'is hadha ya akhi, wallahi, bi'is. What is the secret, so, behind? إذا بحثت القرآن, if you go through the Quran, you will find out that the majority of the commands, once it comes to the relationship between the father and the son, or the father and the daughter, is commanding that child to be dutiful to the parent. 5 times, 5 times, في القرآن. And you know what? only one time commanding the father or the mother to be nice or kind, or to basically be mindful of the children. اللي هي يوصيكم الله في أولادكم. And you know where? In what area? Once it came to inheritance, dividing your wealth as a parent. Because what some parents do these days, they have 3, 4, 5 children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed the love of one of them more than the other in his heart. He would do what? He would give this one he loves more than the others. Allah is telling you, no, yusikumullahu fi awladikum. No, give them equally. وفي السنة, in the sunnah there is a beautiful hadith that explained this. وهو في البخاري حديث النعمان بن بشير رضي الله عنه. Sayyidina Bashir, the father of النعمان, he wanted to give النعمان, he had more than one, في أحد الروايات 12 children. He wanted to give النعمان something special. His wise wife, والله نساء المؤمنين الأول, may Allah give us more. قالت له, go and ask the Prophet regarding this, and it would be good if you would actually get the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to bear witness on this. فجاء بشير, سيدنا بشير came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. قال يا رسول الله إني أريد أن أنحل أو أنحل للنعمان ولدي هذا نحلة, and I want you to bear witness. He said, did you give his other, your other children the same? قال لا. He said, go. This is falsehood. وأنا لا أشهد على زور. Here it is, brothers and sisters in Islam. The love that your father and your mother have for you, يسمونه أهل العلم الحب الفطري. They were fashioned to love you. أنا أقول لك شيء. And here is a مقياس, here is a measurement. The only one that you wish to be better than you is your child. The only one. Don't even pretend that you like me to be like better than, no. The only one is your child. حب, your fashion to love your child. And that love drives them to do all what it takes. يعني subhanAllah, when your child gets sick, you will be willing to do whatever it takes to cure, to remedy, to find a healing. And sometimes you go to a doctor that he tells you maybe, and you do not spare a penny. And sometimes you actually violate your tawheed. واحد بتاع دجل وشعوزة يقول لك ايه, get this and do this, you go and do it. Because of that love. شوف, in the other hand, the son, his father gets sick and he knows that he's about to leave. And the people ask him, how is your father doing? ادعي له, ربنا يحسن ختامه. Make dua for him. الأب, الأم, no. That is why, brothers and sisters in Islam, في صحيح مسلم الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لا يجزي ولد والده إلا أن يجده مملوكا فيعتقه. The only time you can pay back your father or your mother for what they did to you, in one case, you come to this dunya, you find them enslaved and you free them from slavery. The only time. في الأدب المفرد حديث عبد الله بن عباس, وفي روايات أنه ابن عمر, a Bedouin was carrying, came from Yemen, was carrying his mother on his shoulder and he's doing tawaf with her. His mother is an elder, she cannot do tawaf. He carried her. He met Ibn Abbas. وفي رواية أنه ابن عمر. يعني. فقال له يا ابن عباس. He told him, يا ابن عباس, did I pay her back? Did I give her back what she did for you? يقول ابن عباس ولا طلقة واحدة من طلقاتها. Not even one groan from the groans of delivery. ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها. كره. Brothers and sisters in Islam, من أكبر الكبائر كما في حديث أبي بكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said one of the greatest sins, major sins in Islam, عقوق الوالدين, that you are abusive to your parents. وبعدين يعني I wanna tell you something about abusive here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala identified the standard. You know what is the standard? وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ. هذه يعني some of the people of knowledge wrote books about why أُفْ. لِأَنَّهَا كَلِمَةً لَا تَفْتَحُ فِيهَا بِهَا فَمَكْ. أوف. You don't open your mouth. أوف. You could say أُفْ without opening your mouth. You don't open your mouth. Look now. The child must have the last word. If he does not have the last word, you're not going to sleep tonight. Uff, uff. هذا. ولا تقل لهما أف ولا تنهرهما وقل لهما قولا كريما وقل لهما قولا كريما. Speak to them in a respectful way. أكبر الكبائر. شوف, look at the next one. Look at the next one. ثلاثة لا يقبل الله منهم صرفا ولا عدلا. Three kind of people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept their mandatory acts nor their voluntary acts. One of them is العاق والديه, the one who is abusive to his parents. Mushkila. That Allah, you pray and you fast, and Allah does not accept your ibadah, even your voluntary acts, because of the way that you're treating your parents. في كتاب الكبائر للإمام الذهبي, الحافظ الذهبي, ابن عباس has a beautiful statement. He said, ثلاث آيات نزلت مقرونة بثلاث. There are three ayat, verses in the Quran, they were revealed combined with others, like the two ayat, like pairs. Here it is, three pairs. One, وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. If you obey Allah and you do not obey the messenger, no good. They must come together. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاءَ together. أَنِ اشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ. Be grateful to me and to your parents. If you're not grateful to your parents, you will not be grateful to me. يعني هذا المعنى, يعني this meaning is taken from a hadith في سنن الترمذي. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم مَنْ لَا يَشْكُرُ النَّاسَ لَا يَشْكُرُ اللَّهَ. If you don't say thank you to a human being, to the person who did you a favor, how are you going to give thanks to Allah? The human being is right there in front of you. She brought you up, carried you in her womb for 7, 8, 9 months, delivered you, breastfed you, wiped your body, cleaned you. When you were sick, she could not sleep. I mean, how can you be ungrateful, la'im, to this one? And then you want to be grateful to Allah? You don't see Allah. Here is somebody who did you a favor. She, he brought you up while you are young. And you cannot say thank you to them. You cannot say thank you to them. How are you going to say thank you to Allah? من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله. والأولى بالشكر والدين. طب listen to this one. ثنتاني. والحديث أخرجه البخاري في التاريخ بسند صحيح والطبراني الإمام الطبراني في المعجم. Two things that you must taste the consequences of doing them in this world before the hereafter. One, البغي الظلم. If you commit injustice to another human being. Two, والعقوق. If you are abusive to your parents. وهذا القول هو لا يصح عن النبي. بروا آباءكم تبركم أبناؤكم. يعني الحديث ضعيف لكن المعنى موجود. Be dutiful and kind to your parents, your children will be kind to you. الله يعني يحكي هذا أحد المشايخ يعني أنا سمعت يقول لك two individuals, a father and a son, were quarreling in the market. Fighting, arguing, and then turned into fighting. For the son, then the son started beating his father up in the market, jumping on him. يعني هذا, this is something that happened. Jumped on him and started beating him up. For the people came rushing to stop the son from carrying on. He said, ذروه, leave him. I have beaten my father in that place before. Leave him. إياك, إياك, إياك وأبويك. Be careful that your parents do not make dua on you. يستجاب الدعاء. Allah will answer their dua. Brothers and sisters in Islam, their companionship is Jannah. Here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed you in your way. In your way. A deed that can be utilized to get to Jannah. Don't waste it. Otherwise, the dua of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the dua of Jibreel against you will take place. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم رغم أنفه رغم أنفه رغم أنفه, meaning it's may he lose من أدرك أبواه أو أحدهما ولم يدخلاه الجنة. That you come to this dunya and you find your father and mother alive or one of them, and that deed does not qualify you to receive the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to get to Jannah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we have a lot of our Muslim brothers and sisters who happen to have non-Muslim parents. And also some of us have already lost their parents. What can be done for those two? A Muslim whose parents are non-Muslims. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما جاءته أسماء, when Asma The daughter of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she asked him, Ya Rasulullah, my mother is a non-Muslim. Should I give her wood? Absolutely. That is the meaning. قال نعم. Should I be kind to her? قال نعم. And this is taken from the Quran. Look. وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطَعْهُمَا. And if they strive, شوف حتى وصلت, it reached the level or the extent that they may want you to disbelieve in Allah. Commit shirk. Obey them not. Obey them not. Obey them not. وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا. And if they want you to become a non-Muslim, obey them not. لَا طَاعَةَ لِمَخْلُوقٍ فِي مَعْصِيَةِ الْخَالِقِ. Don't obey a human being at the expense of the disobedience of Allah. But immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to that person, وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. Yet, tell them no in this area, but give them a good companionship. I cannot see an example in the Quran than a son who came to teach mankind Tawheed. Abu Tawheed, they call him. The father of the prophets. Look, his father used to make the idols for the people. وأنا أسوق هذا الكلام also, I'm talking to my brothers and sisters, because I really mean that. A lot of our youth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bless them with the knowledge of the deen, with the Quran and the Sunnah, and the first people they go and harass is their parents. لا يا أخي لا يصح. Then he would find his father maybe violating the Quran and the Sunnah. Say, father, you're wrong. You cannot do that. And he yells at his father. لا يا أخي. لا. والله ما هكذا علمنا الله. ولا ما هكذا علمنا رسول الله. No. No. Look. Ibrahim عليه السلام, his father was the maker of the idols. Look how he called him to the truth in Surah Maryam. يا أخي, I have not seen a compassionate tone, loving, so loving tone in the Quran between a son calling his father, Ya Abati, Ya Abati, Ya Abati. Who's his father, Akhi? Who is his father? I'm not saying that you obey your father in his wrongdoing. No, no, we already established that. But how should you deliver and convey the truth to your parents? It must be done in the kindest way possible, with hikmah, with wisdom. You cannot turn your father off because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with some knowledge of the deen. You cannot do that. وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. Brothers and sisters in Islam, what happened if your parents passed away? في سنن ابن ماجه وسنن أبي داود حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما, وللأمانة الحديث في سنده ضعف, الحديث في سنده ضعف. عبيد الله الساعدي لم يوثقه إلا ابن حبان, but the rest of the scholars of hadith said he is weak. A man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال يا رسول الله, he said, O messenger of Allah, my two parents passed away. أبوي ماتا. Can I still do something for them? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Na'am, yes. Number one, as-salatu alayhima, meaning making dua for them. You make dua for them. وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. Nuh, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ. Make it, salatu alayhima. Two, الاستغفار لهما, Asking Allah to forgive them. Asking Allah to forgive them. Allahumma ghafir li abi. Allahumma ghafir li ummi. Allahumma ghafir li abaina wa li ummahatina. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Infadu ahdihima. You fulfill their wasiyah. But there is a restriction here. As long as that wasiyah, that will, does not contradict the sharia. If the wasiyah, if his will or her will is matching, is okay in our religion, fulfill it. Four. وَصِلَةُ الرَّحِمِ الَّتِي لَا تَصِلُ إِلَّا بِهِمَا. A kins that your father was always keen on visiting. Go and visit that kin, that kins, a relative. Huh? Five. وَإِكْرَامُ صَدِيقِهِمَا. Your father had a friend. Treat that friend in an honorable way. Brothers and sisters in Islam, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في سنن النسائي ومسند الإمام من حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها دخل الجنة ذات يوم أو قال رأيتني في الجنة. I seen myself in Jannah. And I heard someone reciting Quran in Jannah. فسمعت قراءة القرآن في الجنة. فقلت من هذا؟ I asked, who is reciting the Quran in Jannah? قالوا حارثة ابن النعمان, a companion من أهل البيعة. حارثة ابن النعمان رضي الله عنه. Look what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said. كذلكم البر, كذلكم البر, كذلكم البر, وكان أبر الناس بأمه. لدرجة قيل عنه رضي الله عنه أنه لا يرفع. He does not look at them. He would speak to his mother like this. لا يأكل أمامها. He does not eat in front of her. And listen. كذلكم البر. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, when someone came and asked him, who should deserve my best treatment? من أحق الناس بحسن صحبتي يا رسول الله؟ قال أمك. Your mother. Then who? Your mother. Then who? Your mother. Then who? Then your father. Three times the mother. Why, brothers and sisters in Islam? And with this I close. Why the mother? Why the mother? Why the mother? Why the mother? Because her work is done before you recognize it. Do you recognize her when she's bearing you in her womb? No. Do you see with your own eyes when she delivers you, even so you're being delivered? No. Do you see the pain that she goes through when she breastfeeds? No. Suckling and الفصام. The majority of her work ends before you recognize it. Then the child would then reach a certain age and all he sees, the father providing for the family, the father is making the calls. Then the child may think that the mother did not do a lot for him. And that is why الشريعة, the religion, stressed the mother, the mother, the mother. Be mindful of your parents, brothers and sisters in Islam. They are your way to Jannah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها, أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا اغفر لنا ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.